Past simple or simple past of regular verbs. Well, today we're gonna learn the simple past. Here we have some examples how to use the simple past. The first one we have Marco Giancarlo cooked 176 kilos of spaghetti in one pot on the 26th July 2000. Then we have Samuel James. His wife, four children, and seven cats traveled to France in a Mini Cooper last summer. Then we have Trisha Booth played the piano for 78 hours in October 1999. Another example is Lee Hong tidied her room in 48 seconds in April 2000. Down here, we have the structures of the simple past or the past simple. Okay, so we have in the affirmative, for example, we have I worked, you worked, he worked, she worked, it worked, we worked, you worked, they worked. In the negative full form, I did not work, you did not work, he did not work, she did not work, it did not work, we did not work, you did not work, they did not work. In the short form, we have I didn't work, you didn't work, he didn't work, she didn't work, it didn't work, we didn't work, you didn't work, they didn't work. That's the question. Did I work? Did you work? Did he worked? Did she worked? Did it work? Did we worked? Did you worked? Did they worked? Okay, now we're going to explain the grammar and the use. Okay, so here it says the form, right? We make the past simple of regular verbs with the suffix ed. They played football yesterday. Por ejemplo, aquí tenemos el verbo play. Solamente le agregamos el sufijo ed y se convierte en pasado con los verbos regulares. Okay? Then it says to make the negative, we put the auxiliary verb did not. The short form is didn't before the main verb in its root form. The main verb does not have the suffix ed in the negative. Okay, so here we have, he didn't watch TV last night. He didn't watch TV last night. We cannot say, esto es incorrecto. He didn't watch TV last night. Entonces, en el negativo, pasado, como utilizamos este did ya nos está indicando que está en el pasado. Entonces, como nos indica que está en el pasado, no es necesario poner la terminación ed. Entonces, esta oración es incorrecta. Then it says, in short answers, we use the personal pronoun and did or didn't. We do not repeat the main verb. For example, we have, did you like the film? Yes, I did, or no, I didn't. Bueno, aquí tenemos para las respuestas cortas. Para las respuestas cortas, utilizamos el yes, I did, or no, I didn't. Estos son para yes, no questions, o preguntas en que la respuesta va a ser sí o no. Y no ponemos el main verb, el verbo principal no lo ponemos. En este caso, el verbo principal es like. En las respuestas cortas, solamente utilizamos el verbo auxiliar o el verbo que ayuda al verbo principal hacer. Por ejemplo, que tenemos did aquí, entonces ya no utilizamos este like. Y a la pregunta, did you like the film? ¿Te gustó la película? Se responda, yes, I did, or no, I didn't. ¿Ok? No sería correcto decir, yes, I did like the film, or I did like, or no, I didn't like. That is incorrect, ¿ok? Eso está muy, muy mal. Entonces, una forma de responder, una forma corta de responder preguntas, yes, no, es con yes, I did para el afirmativo, o el no, I didn't para el negativo. Ok, acá tenemos unas reglas ortográficas, spelling rules. Okay, it says with verbs ending in E, we only add D in the past simple positive. For example, we have dance, it turns into danced. Like, for example, we have dance, the ending is the letter E, and then we have, so it turns, since the ending is the letter E, we add ED here. You see? Dance, we add D. And then we have like, and we add D here. Entonces, con las termina los verbos que terminan en E, solamente le agregamos una D. Esto es solamente con los verbos regulares en el pasado. Then it says, with verbs ending in a consonant and Y, the Y goes and we add IED. For example, we have the verb cried. It ends with Y, right? It ends with Y. Sorry, it ends with Y here. Okay? So we omit the Y and we add IED. Then we have the verb study. Study turns from Y, it turns to studied. O sea, la regla nos dice que cuando termina en Y, vamos a omitir esa Y y va a convertirse, va a tener una terminación de IED. Por ejemplo, tenemos aquí cry, it became cried, study, studied. Then we have with verbs ending in a vowel and Y, we add ED as usual. Play, played. Stay, stay, stayed. ¿Ok? Entonces dice, con los verbos que terminan en una vocal e Y, vamos a agregar ED como siempre. Por ejemplo, acá tenemos play, que termina en una vocal que es A and Y. Y le agregamos, como siempre, ED. Stay, A and Y. Y le agregamos ED, como siempre. Then we have with single syllable verbs ending in a vowel and a consonant, we double the consonant and add ED. Okay? For example, we have stop, it becomes stopped. Plan, planned. Dice con verbos que son monosilábicos, o sea, que son de solamente una sílaba, que terminan en una vocal y una consonante, vamos a duplicar la consonante y agregar ED. Aquí, por ejemplo, tenemos stop. Tenemos una vocal y una consonante OP. Entonces, la consonante lo vamos a duplicar. Vamos a duplicar la P y vamos a agregar ED. Stopped. Ok, aquí también plan. Tenemos una vocal y una consonante. Esta combinación nos dice que se va a duplicar la consonante y le vamos a agregar. Se va a duplicar la consonante y le vamos a agregar ED. ¿Ok? Then let's talk about the use. ¿Ok? El uso. ¿Cuándo utilizamos el past simple? It says, we use the past simple to talk about something that happened at a specific time in the past. We can answer a question asking when the action happened. Okay? For example, we have, she finished her homework an hour ago. When did she finish her homework? An hour ago. Okay? Entonces dice, para hablar de algo que sucedió en un tiempo determinado o específico en el pasado. Podemos responder una pregunta. Podemos responder una pregunta cuando la acción sucedió. Por ejemplo, dice, she finished her homework an hour ago. When did she finish her homework? An hour ago. Entonces, esta es la forma cuando podemos responder cuándo sucedió exactamente. Nos quiere decir que es un tiempo específico en el pasado. ¿Ok? Es un tiempo específico en el pasado. Entonces, cuando es un tiempo específico en el pasado, utilizamos el simple past. ¿Ok? When did she finish her homework? An hour ago. El tiempo específico en el pasado fue an hour ago. Una hora atrás. O hace una hora. Cuando tenemos este tiempo específico, utilizamos el simple past or past simple. Okay, then we have, he visited Rome last year. We watched a good film on TV last night. Again, we have last year and last night. Both are specific time in the past. So we know exactly when that action happened. Okay? For example, we could ask, he visited Rome last year, right? When did he visit Rome? Last year, right? So we have that specific time in the past. That's why we use simple past or past simple. Then we have here, we watched a good film on TV last night. When did we watch a good film on TV? Last night. So this last night is el tiempo específico en el pasado. Lo mismo que last year. Okay? Then it says to talk about a series of actions one after the other. We listen to music, we dance, and then we open our presents. Okay? Entonces cuando hablamos de acciones consecutivas, que ocurre una después de la otra. O sea, esto quiere decir que primero we listen to music, then después we dance, and then we open our presents. Entonces, esas acciones ocurrieron en ese orden, en un orden consecutivo. Primero escuchamos música, bailamos y después abrimos los regalos. We also use the simple past with time phrases such as last year, last month, last week, last Monday, 3 years ago, 2 days ago, yesterday morning, yesterday afternoon, in 1987, and in 1996. Okay, todas estas frases de tiempo los vamos a utilizar con el pasado simple. Acá puede ser cualquier año. In 2010, in 2012, in 1600, in 1900. So all these are a specific time in the past. Okay, so we have all these. This is the use for the simple past. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me for YouTube or the website japonica.co.cc. Thank you.